Rémi is with us from Saint-Aduc. I was at the winery last year, and Rémi asked me, can you recommend a good importer? And so I did, and less than 12 months later, the wine is here at this tasting, so I'm very happy. And we have a Gigondas, which is, of course, from the southern Rhone, very near to Châteauneuf-du-Pape, but slightly higher elevation, and the terroir is a little bit different. You don't have the big stones of the Châteauneuf-du-Pape. You have more either limestone, but this wine is coming from a red soil terroir, so iron clay, I think you could say, and very traditional style for the southern Rhone. This is a blend of Grenache, Syrah, and some Cinsault old vines, very low yield bush vines. It looks like, you know, macchia, really Mediterranean macchia. From afar, it doesn't look like a vineyard. It looks like bushes, like a scrub. A very, very low yield. You wouldn't like to produce wine there. The yield can sometimes be something like 20 hectoliters per hectare from a vineyard. And a wine is a good discussion wine, because there is a bit of the funk that Susan was referring to before. I think on some competitions, like IWC, where Susan is a panel chair, or decanter, where I judge, this wine would get rejected. There would be some judges on the panel who would say, oh, this is faulty, let's send it away. Let's open another bottle if they are being optimistic. But of course, the other bottle is going to be the same, because this is not a bottle problem. It is not a bottle fault. This is a character of the wine. So it's very meaty. It's very savory. There is, a low element of bread. Would you agree, Susan? On some Saint-Aduc wines, there is a bit more. On some, there is a bit less. This is a part of the game. Like many estates in the Rhone, you have the breads in the environment, and as you know, it's a very difficult thing to control in the winery. Yeah, you have to, there's not really a way to 100% eliminate bread from your winery or from your wine. So if you have it, it's better to try to balance it, I think, with some other characters in the wine than to be obsessed with getting rid of it. Do you agree?
I tune into Brett, not deliberately, but sometimes I get the slightly extra dry finish, as if a little bit of the fruit has been sculpted and taken out, almost like someone's taken an ice cream scoop and taken out the fruit towards the end. So it just feels a little extra gathering dryness. It's a hard thing once when you tune into something, it's very difficult not to notice it. So, and the only thing you can do really is be true to your impressions. But this one, I think, has other things going on. And I guess that's really the balance that we're talking about, that Wojciech is talking about. Some wines, of course, the famous Chateau Massart, have a lot of Brett, but they also have other things which are kind of adding to the complexity. And taking you away from just focusing on what maybe many people consider a fault. So I think it's a tricky thing to balance. But something interesting I discovered recently, I had always thought that if a wine has Brett, it's going to be the same in every bottle. But that's not the case. Actually, there's quite a bit of bottle variation. So it may be that you notice it more on one bottle than another, and another somehow has managed to get less of it. So it's an interesting and controversial topic, and we have lots of discussions about that on our panels. But, you know, it's still one. Another thing to say is that, in general, consumers like some of those characteristics. I have to say, they do like a certain element of this leathery, gamey, horsey character. I'm not getting that on this particular wine, but when it is on a wine, customers in general, people who are not involved in the trade, do tend to actually like that.
Okay, I think we don't have any clinical wines on the tasting today. We don't really have any picture-perfect wines on the tasting today. We have wines with a lot of character and personality, and so they might sometimes have elements that you dislike, you know, a bit of Brett here, some oxidation there, you know, tannins in the white wines. But this is what they are. They are the expression of the place, the expression of a style, expression of the winemakers. The Italians have a lovely phrase that I keep using, vino d'autore, the wine of an author. And this is what we're talking about, because, of course, wine at the highest level of quality is always the expression of a person, of an individual, not only of the place and the grape variety. And I think a bit of Brett is just an element of the character of the Rhone wines, and we are talking about a very ancient wine region, super classic, you know, the first that really challenged Bordeaux and Burgundy by making wines of the highest quality, at least in France. And so it, for me, it really fits in this wine because, as Susan said, the finish is juicy and sweet, not really that sort of drying, sweaty, unpleasant that you get when there is too much bread.